straight from the corner of our studio where she has raced across all of these cameras and has made it so beautifully is Simone Kessell.
Are you okay? Do you need to take a breath?
Oh, yes, I do. Thank you. Thank you for running. We appreciate the urgency.
Right? And I can fill the time by raving because I was watching Yellowjackets this morning and, oh, boy. Look, the short, like, plot summary is it's a show about a girls' soccer team, but it is not, like, Bend It Like Beckham, a show about a girls' soccer team. It is so much more. How would you sum it up?
How would I sum up Yellowjackets? Basically, it's set in the 90s and the present day and... The plane goes down. There's survivors, but how do they survive? And then it's intertwined with past and present. And it's pretty terrifying.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That is
you okay?
I'm kind of not, but I like it.
Yeah, you can't take your eyes off it.
That's what Susie said. The review was terrifying.
Yes.
It's terrifying, but it's funny. There's a little bit of funny in there.
Well, you mentioned the cast, and, of course, if you're covering, you know, across an expanse of decades, it's a huge ensemble cast. Yes. You've also got the likes of Christina Ricci, Melanie Lynskey, Juliette Lewis involved in this as well.
Yes, I work a lot with Juliette.
Yeah. Who are you most excited to work with?
Well, coming on to the show, I was very happy because Melanie Lynskey, who's a fellow New Zealander, she's on the show and she's a wonderful, such a generous actress. And so coming into the show, I had Melanie as my antipodean and then Courtney Eaton, who plays the younger version of the Lottie Matthews character. So I had that foundation to kind of work from. And I have to say, they're big boots to fill. Look at the show. I mean, it's such a stellar cast. The locations are amazing. Mm. Everyone's a little bit unhinged.
Do you mean the characters or the...
On and off screen. Okay, yeah, there's some typecasting there. So
It is two different time periods. So there's an ensemble cast for the later period and then one for the earlier. Do you actually cross paths?
No, it's like we're shooting two different shows.
Okay.
So we never really get to work together. And we film it in Vancouver and... It's a pretty horrific show to make because not only the elements but the characters that we're dealing with, but it's definitely a unique show and one that I think everyone can really get into.
We've been keeping extremely busy. You're also in the new Disney Obi-Wan Kenobi reboot or whatever has been happening, which
what
I love.
That?
I don't know. You play Princess Leia's adoptive mother.
Yes, Breya Organa.
Yes, and I imagine that coming into that with such a... Were you intimidated at all by the fan base at all? Were you just like, I've done a million things, I don't care?
The fan base, it's like church. Mm. You know, it's a religion. Star Wars is a religion. And I was overwhelmed by the fan base. And this is very funny. So I was in Los Angeles recently and I rolled through a stop sign, right, which is kind of not what you do. But anyway, the sirens go, the cop pulls me over. And I'm sitting in the car and I've got my hands up. And he's like, ma'am, you can put your hands down. And I was like, oh my God.
Stress.
Oh my God.
Stress.
Like this, right? You've got no drugs, but you think you've got drugs. And so I was like, okay. And I, you know, and I'm there and he's like, license registration. And I'm like, I'm from New Zealand. In the strongest Kiwi accent. I tried the New Zealand card, right? I was like, I'm going to play the New Zealand card. So I go, I'm from New Zealand, like that. And he goes, what, they don't have stop signs in New Zealand? And I was like, oh, that's not going to work. And as I'm reaching for my registration, I go, I'm in Star Wars. I played the Star Wars card.
Oh, my gosh.
Like this. And he goes... What character? And I knew then that I had completely gotten off the ticket. So
what a gift, right?
I want those cards. I wish I had those cards.
Right, you saw, yeah, the Star Wars card is a good one to play.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Oh, goodness. Well, another thing, before we go, we have to ask you about one other thing you did, one of your other iconic roles. Take a look at this. You were in a show called Thorpe's Undercover Angels.
Do you remember?
Oh, my Lord.
In 2003.
I didn't think they had the internet.
Show.
There was internet?
Yeah, and you obviously are killing it in Hollywood nowadays. But when you look back at those pictures,
what... Did you find
that? Well, that scouring the globe, Ian Thorpe.
He's been digging it up all afternoon.
Yeah. Man, weren't you?
Also, it's great. It was one of the biggest, sports stars in Australia, plus three incredible, angels, which is what, I mean, it feels like you've come a long way since then. Do you remember anything about that show? We want to know everything about it.
They might reboot it. So yes. I have to be careful. The show was basically us doing good things, right? And there's Jackie and Katie and Thorpe. And from that, Thorpe and I we're still very, very close friends. Look at that.
The graphic design, the promos,
well,
the source material.
We still love Thorpe, of course. You can catch Simone in season 2 of Yellowjackets, premiering on Paramount Plus next Friday. Would you please give it up for Simone?